Hello, my name is Vikas Chaudhary and I am a 3D designer. This is my first free training on the internet, so please subscribe me on www.youtube.com/globaldesigns3D. Before we are going to the topic, first I will give you a short brief about my first series. In this series, I plan to create 3 architectural designing trainings, which is available in Architectural Designing 101, which is related to modeling, and the second one is Architectural Designing Volume 2, related to texturing and the materialing, and last and the final one is Architectural Designing Volume 3, related to lighting and the rendering. So this is my first chapter, introduction from the modeling volume, and today I am here to show you how to create a photorealistic 3D render in 3ds Max. And in this volume I will show you how you can create a 3D scene with the help of an actual image. Basically, I don't have any CAD drawing or any other dimension detail for this design. So I'm just tracing an image in 3D Studio Max. So let's get started. Hello everyone, this is Vikas Chaudhary and today I will teach you how to create this kind of 3D scene in 3D Max and V-Ray. Today I will start with some reference modeling like pillars, planters, and creating railings and lights, etc. So let's get started. Hi, welcome again. So first we started with how to import this image in our 3D Max. Create a simple plane in your front view and just drag and drop this image on that plane so it will appear in the your 3D scene. And now I'm applying a UV map on this plane. said it should be look like 16 inches. So just create a box. And set its dimension is 16 inches. 16 inches and 16 inches. So it's too big. And our background image and the model is very small. So just select your model first and arrange this into the box. Just scale your model your background image. First you need to set a camera angle for deciding the view of your camera. So go to the top view, select the camera, target camera, and just click on viewport. Go to the scene, just delete this box and increase the background image. Your camera a little bit upside, so it should look like a perspective view. Move your planter like that and increase the scale a little bit more. Yeah, that's fine. Now I'm going a little bit more back for adjusting my image in the viewport. Press Ctrl F for your image and set the resolution of your rendering. Default it should be 640 by 480, and now it's up to you which resolution do you want. I want to reduce the little bit height of my scene, so I'm just reducing this. It should like this. Lock this and increase the resolution to around 1000. That's okay. I'll just close the tab. Now finally we create the planter base, and now I'm starting to create a pillar. Hi, welcome again. In the previous lesson I will teach you how to create a planter for your scene, and now I will create a floor in your scene. So just